Thank you. I greet you all in the name of Jesus. I am so grateful again that today I'm able to come again to you to share the living word of God. I want to greet the pastor, Reverend Eunice Tirango. I want to greet all of the leadership of Kenya Global Church. I do really appreciate this opportunity that you have given unto me to be able to come to you with a word of life. I do thank you very much, Mama Mark, for reaching out. And I do thank God for each and every one of us that God has given us this opportunity today again to be able to share from His word. I have a word from the Lord, and we are going to read. Thank you very much for the wonderful prayer, servant of God. I want us to read from the Bible, from Proverbs chapter 29 and verse number 18. The Bible says, I'll read several versions. In King James Version, it says, "Where there is no vision, the people perish, but he that keepeth the law, happy is he." I'll also read from the Message translation, which says, "If people can't see what God is doing, they stumble all over themselves. But when they attend to what he reveals, they are most blessed." Also, the New Living Translation says, "When people do not accept divine guidance, they run wild. But whoever obeys the law is joyful." Last but not least, let me read from the New International Version. I also like this. It says, "Where there is no revelation, people cast off restraint. But blessed is the one who heeds wisdom's instruction." Children of God, do thank God for this medium of technology, that you being on the other side of the oceans and we being on this side of the oceans, still we are able to touch base. And I have a word. I'll speak on this topic. What do you see? Niki urona. What do you see? Unaona nini? From the text that we have read, we find a key word, vision. And just the normal dictionary translation of vision, a definition of vision, is a faculty or state of being able to see. Or also is an ability to think or plan the future with imagination or wisdom. In the spiritual sense, man is a tripartite being, meaning man is body, soul, and spirit. And Jesus says that them that worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. So God being spirit, we connect with him in the spirit. Just as our natural body has eyes for physical vision, so does our spiritual man also has eyes of spiritual vision. And the context of our text today is spiritual seeing or spiritual vision. This is the link between where we are now and where we want to be. When this vision is absent, the scripture says that the people are destroyed. And that from another translation we saw that people are unrestrained. They lack discipline. People live without restraints. People make uninformed decisions. They have barriers, embargoes in fulfilling the purpose for which we are here on earth. When people lack vision, people get stuck. There is no progress. God works with us within the parameters of our spiritual vision. In Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 11 and 12, the Bible says, as God asked Jeremiah a question, Jeremiah, what do you see? And Jeremiah answers back to God that I see a branch of an almond tree. And verse number 12, the Bible says that you have well seen, Jeremiah. I will hasten my word to perform it. I will watch over my word to perform what you have seen. God is telling Jeremiah that he will watch over his word to fulfill what Jeremiah has seen in the spirit realm. Here we see something very important. God commends Jeremiah for seeing well. He tells him, you have well seen, because I will follow after my word to perform that which you have seen. In the Gospel of Mark chapter 8, verse number 22, Jesus comes to Bethsaida, and a blind man is brought to Jesus. Jesus takes the blind man, and then he leads him out of the city. What do we see here? Sometimes our environment can really limit our perspective. Well, the things we are used to see, the things that surround us, things that we encounter day to day, can limit our perspective. The Bible says, continue to say in Mark chapter 8, from verse 22, that Jesus spits on the eyes of this blind man and puts his hand upon him and asks him if he saw anything. The man replies, I see men as trees. Jesus lays hands on him again and he begins to see clearly. Sometimes in life we don't see things clearly in the spirit realm, and what we see mostly is what we get. Look at the Bible, the 10 spies. When they are sent to go out and spy out the land of Canaan, all 12 of them, 10 come back, and every one of those 12, they saw the same things. Every one of the 12, they were in the same place. And when the 10 come back, they say this, that we saw ourselves as grasshoppers in our own sight. And so we were in our sight. You see, this is interesting. They saw themselves as grasshoppers. And as they saw themselves as grasshoppers, so they were grasshoppers in their own sight. We need the touch of God so that we can see clearly. Because when we don't see clearly, we will not be able to see the promises of God. We are living in days which are so challenging. The challenges that we are receiving and going and we experience every day are things which are so make us so weary. They tire you down. They want to pin you down. They kind of bring us to a place where it's as if the promises of God are not valid anymore. But here, our sight, our spiritual sight, is very, very important. Again, let me draw our attention to Moses in Hebrews chapter 11 and verse number 23. The Bible says that by faith, Moses, when he was born, was hid 3 months of his parents because they saw, waliona, that he was a proper child, and they were ready to defy the king's commandment of throwing the male children into the river. We see that in Exodus chapter 1, verse number 22. And in Exodus chapter 2, verse 2, the mother of Moses saw that this was a goodly child, a good child. I'm not going to throw him into the river. See, what we see will determine our actions. What we'll see will determine the things, how we will take things, how we will take the word of God, how we will take our lives. All depends on this kind of spiritual vision that we have. Your life, your health, your career. What are you seeing right now in whatever situation that you are in? You might be having a case, an immigration case. What are you seeing? Are you seeing you going, are you seeing yourself going through? Are you seeing yourself sailing by the grace of God to a place that all shall be well with you? What are you seeing? What you see or don't see will determine the far that you will go. Vision, that is spiritual vision, is a prerequisite to progress. I'll also look at Abraham. At that time he was called Abram and Lot in Genesis chapter 13 and verse 7. There was strife between the herdsmen of Abram and Lot's men because of pasture. And strife that they had, Abraham being older, he called his nephew and he told him that this land that we are in is so big. Let us choose which part of the land you want to take. And Lot chose the well-watered plain of Jordan. Abraham remained with the dry places, the mountain places. But I thank God that anytime you go with the covenant and the promises of God, wherever you go, God will go with you. Right now, those of you that are in Canada, you are there by God's grace. God has planted your feet there. And you are not there by chance. You are not there by luck. You are there by God's own doing. Regardless of the circumstances that happen for you to find yourself there, it is God that has planted you there. And because it is God that has planted you there, no devil, no power of darkness is able to uproot you out of that place as long as you see yourself being there by the will of God. You are not there by the will of man. Yes. You're not there by the will of man. You're there by the will of God. And as you see that, that establishes the purpose of God for you. Choose. And about this part of this portion of scripture that in Genesis chapter 13, the Bible, when Lot separated from Abraham, Abraham told him to choose the land. And then he separated himself from Abraham. And when after he had separated himself from Abraham, in verse 14 of chapter number 13, the Bible says, "And the Lord said unto Abraham, after Lot was separated from him, lift up now your eyes and look from the place where you are, northward and southward, eastward and westward. For all the land which you see, to you will I give it and to your seed forever." As far as you can see, God will give you. Open your vision and scope. You see, God is asking Jeremiah, what are you seeing? God is asking you today, my brother, my sister, what are you seeing? Because what you see is what you're going to get from God. Because where there is no vision, people perish. Where there is no vision, there is no restraint. Where there is no vision, people don't have a plan of where they are going. Where there is no vision, it's like everything is blind, like everything is dark. We must be able to I tell God, open my spiritual eyes that I may see. I refuse what the script that the devil has written for my life. You know, sometimes even in life, there are things that people say negatively against us, and we think, we get so fearful, and we think that we have everything in our lives is going to fall according to the script of the things that people have said against us. Sometimes we go through situations which are tough, like right now, as we are going through all of this pandemic, it can bring such a fear in our hearts that kind of like we want to fashion our lives according to whatever is happening. We forget that the promises of God are yes and amen, and whatever God has said is the final word for us. So today God is calling us. What are you seeing even in this pandemic? Are you seeing yourself getting to the other side of the pandemic? Even in whatever you're going through right now, are you seeing yourself getting to the other side? What are you seeing? Vision is hampered when we walk in the flesh. For Abraham, Lot, his nephew, was a form or a symbol of the flesh. And that brought strife. Tukiwa watu wa mwili, kila kitu nataka kuona kimwili, everything we look at it in the eyes of the natural. We don't look at it in the eyes of God. Then we hamper what God wants to show us. We hamper seeing the power of God. The Bible says, God is the God of flesh. Is there anything too hard for him? But when we walk in the flesh, kind of like we want to have the physical reasoning of man, we are not just humble enough to look at the word and believe the word and see God working on our behalf, then we will hamper ourselves. Tutajizuia, we will hinder ourselves from coming to the full manifestation of all that God wants to do in our lives. What are you seeing? Sight is very important. There is a story that is told of the first president of the Republic of Uganda. His name was Milton Obote. Milton Obote, the story goes that in the last year that he did his high school exams, on the last day of those exams, he took a high ladder and he climbed at one of the very visible walls. And he wrote up on that wall in bold letters that Milton Obote, the future president of the Free Republic of Uganda. That was still, Uganda hadn't got her independence then. He was still a high school student. He has just done his high school exams. But in his eyes, he could see himself being the president of Uganda whenever Uganda was going to have her independence. And that actually happened. What you see, you become. What are you seeing? In history, we have this American preacher, Martin Luther King. He began to say, I have a dream that one day my daughters will walk hand to hand with the whites. He began to see a time that there's going, the racism will be eradicated out of America, that the black man and the white man will be able to vote in the same place. And he began to say, I have a dream. Martin Luther's dream happened. And it didn't just happen. A black president sat in the White House of the United States of America. What you see is so powerful. What do you see? That is a question for us today. Let me come back to Abraham. Only after Abraham had separated from Lot did God tell him to lift his eyes and see. What are you seeing? What are you seeing? There was a young man in 2 Kings chapter 2. Elisha, he told Elijah, he began to follow Elijah wherever Elijah was going. And as they were going to Gilgal, and then they went to Bethel, Then they went to Jericho. And then they crossed the Jordan. And Elijah asked Elisha, "What do you want?" And Elisha replied that, "I want a double of the anointing that is upon you." And Elijah told him, "You have asked for a hard thing, but if you see me go, you will receive." And so, as they crossed the Jordan, and they went to the other side, and then there was a whirlwind, and then there was a fire, and then Elijah was taken in the chariots of fire, and he saw Elijah going. I believe this Elijah was transformed. It was a spiritual sense. He was actually not seeing him now in this physical sense, because Elijah was being taken by heaven. And so here, he saw Elijah being taken, and he received that double portion of the anointing that he requested from Elijah. What are you seeing? What are you seeing? There was Elisha now had a helper who was called Gehazi. Gehazi had a big problem. You see, Elijah received a double portion of the anointing that was on Elijah. But now there was Elisha, now when he came back from receiving the mantle, when he came back to the river Jordan, he just asked, "Where's the God of Elijah?" And the waters parted. You see, he received something because he saw. Our spiritual side is so important. And then here, he has a young man called Gehazi. Gehazi always had this problem. One day he wakes up, and as he goes out, he sees they're all surrounded with the Syrian army. And he goes back to the house and is telling his master, Elisha, that, "Oh, today our ministry is over. Today our lives are over." Then, you know, Elisha, because he's operating in the spirit realm, actually, he used to see what the king of Assyria was planning in his bed chamber, in his bedroom. Elisha used to see. He was not seeing it with the natural eyes. He was seeing it with his spiritual eyes. Oh, my brothers and my sisters, how I pray that God will begin to open our eyes, that we'll begin to see things, that things will not happen to you. Zinakustua. You, God, when your spiritual eyes will open, you'll begin to see vision. You'll begin to see dreams. You'll begin to see things. You will not be caught by surprise by the enemy. But our eyes must be opened. Hallelujah. 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 Then Gehazi, because he was always operating in the flesh, one day, the man of God, Naaman, the Syrian soldier, comes because he has leprosy. He has been told by his maid that if you would go to the man of God in Israel, you will be healed. Then Naaman goes, and as he goes, to make a long story short, he goes to the king. The king kind of tears his clothes, thinking that now this king wants war with me. I cannot heal a man. Then when Elisha hears the story, then when Naaman goes to Elisha, Elisha tells him, "Go and wash yourself 7 times in the Jordan." Then Naaman, because he was always reasoning in the flesh, he thinks, back in Damascus, we have Abana and Pafa, clean rivers, not like this messed up, dirty river of Jordan. What do you mean? You see, my brothers and my sisters, the instructions of God must be obeyed. So the servant of God, Naaman, tells Naaman, "Just do it, just do it." He goes and 7 times, and the 7th time when he goes into the water, his skin comes out like the skin of a baby. And then Elisha, because he didn't want anything, Naaman takes to him money, Naaman takes to him clothes, Naaman takes to him gold. Elisha says no. But Gehazi, because he was always operating in the flesh, see, now when Elisha was sleeping, then Gehazi, he runs after Naaman, and he tells Naaman that, "We have received a guest. I won't go by. We have received a guest, and now the man of God has said, give me half of what you are supposed to bring." And Gehazi, because he was not always keen to see spiritually, Gehazi He inherited leprosy. You see, the servant of Elijah inherited double portion because he was able to see. But now, the servant of Elisha, who was now to receive even a big anointing, now receives leprosy. Let me draw you back. There was this time that when he saw all of these soldiers surrounding them, and he went to the man of God. All that the man of God prayed for him, the man of God prayed and said, God, open his eyes. And then when his eyes were opened, he could see the whole mountain full of chariots of fire, because Elisha had told him that many of them who are with us, who he was seeing with his spiritual eyes, many of them who are with us. In these times, we need to believe the word of God. We need our spiritual eyes to be open. At your place of work, if your spiritual eyes are not open, oh, my brother, my sister, you'll face some challenges. In your family, if the spiritual eyes are not open, there are some things that will catch you by surprise. Even as a church, when the spiritual eyes are not open, there are challenges that the enemy will bring in the church. Oh, how I pray that the eyes of our understanding will be open, that we'll begin to see all that God has planned. We'll begin to see God for who he is. You know, sometimes when our spiritual eyes are not open, we think that the devil, that God is a competitor of the devil. Kind of like everything, oh, shetani alifanya, oh, shetani alifanya, oh, shetani alifanya, oh, negoma, 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 hii, negoma, area. When you have a spiritual understanding, you will know that even what the enemy brings will work out together for your good. Oh, yes, you will know that the love of God, that God has loved you with such a love that the Bible says that who can separate us from the love of God? The hunger cannot separate us. Persecution cannot separate us. Death cannot separate us, because God has loved us with an eternal love. But if we don't see this, we will not be able to appropriate it. We must see it with a spiritual eye, that when you wake up, you just shut your natural eyes and you say, today I see God working on my behalf. Today I see God working on this boy. Today I see God working on this child. Yes, things can delay, but I tell you, delay is not denial. Yes, when you look at that child, you can look at them and you say, I know that God is at work both to do and to will of his good pleasure. And yes, right now they might be acting up, but they are coming. God will arrest them. You must see it. Refuse to see what the devil is showing you. You are believing for your loved one, and you see situations coming from bad to worse, from worse to worse. Keep on believing. Keep on believing, my sister. Keep on believing, my brother. Keep on believing, because God is faithful. He who began a good work in you will bring it to completion. Yes, the enemy can make everything look kind of like impossible, but yes, the Bible says God is the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for God? God is on your case and is able to do that which man cannot do. We just sang a song a few minutes ago. Unafanya mambo, mwanadamu hawezi kutenda. He makes a way upon many waters. Yes, he can bring a comfort that no man can be able to give you. Yes, he can be able to do things that nobody else can be able to do. Yes, he's able. But we must cooperate with him. What are you seeing? He told Jeremiah, you have well seen, and so I will follow after my word to perform it. Are you giving God the raw material to work on? Are you giving God an opportunity to work on? Are you locating yourself in the place that God can work your signs and wonders and miracles? The Bible says in Isaiah, say unto the righteous, it shall be well with them, it shall be well with us. Even in this pandemic, it shall be well with us. Even in whatever you're going through, it shall be well with you, your son, your daughter. You're going to see the power of God upon their lives, because God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above that which we ask or think, according to the power that works in us. The Bible says in Jeremiah 33, verse number 3, call upon me, and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things that you know not. But are you seeing? What are you seeing? What are you seeing? I must close this. Gehazi missed a great inheritance. Elisha died, and even when he died with the anointing in his bones, such that one day when some soldiers were coming, and somebody saw somebody died, and they were thrown in upon the bones of Elisha, that person rose. What was the anointing doing in bones? That anointing was supposed to be transferred to Gehazi, but because he didn't have spiritual vision, he was always blind to the things of God. He was always not seeing. Alikuwa anaona vitu tofauti. Elisha anaona vitu za Mungu, yeye anaona vitu za kushindwa. Are you seeing yourself being a failure? Are you seeing yourself coming into shame? That is not what God has planned for you. God has not planned any defeats for you. The Bible says about how the things that God has planned for those that he has already called unto him. And the Spirit is reminding me of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse number 10. That the God of all grace, who has called us into his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, will make you perfect. Number one. Number two, he will establish you. Number three, he will settle you. Yes, God will settle you. Right now, kind of like you're wondering, Pastor Moses, how is God going to settle me in this land of Canada? Yes, God will settle you after you have suffered a while. Sit with your eyes. God is going to settle you. Last but not least, the Bible says God will strengthen you. Let me read this portion of scripture in Ephesians chapter 1 and verse number 15. Paul knew that the church in Ephesus would be limited without vision. So we see him praying for the church. And verse number 17 of chapter 1, Paul says that I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him. Then verse number 18, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, tochi mulike, mwangaza imulike, macho ya ufahamu, be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power to us who believe, according to the working of his mighty power, which he produced in Christ when he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places, far above all principality and power and might and dominion and every name that is named, that in this world, and that which is to come. See, that is the privilege proposition that God has given you. What are you seeing? What you see in the spirit realm will give God the raw material to work with. Where there is no vision, people will perish. Where there is no spiritual vision, Paul says, we do not see Christ according to the flesh. We see him according to the spirit. Sometimes even people miss their blessing because they look at things according to the flesh. Today may the Lord help us that we'll be able to see things according to the spirit. There is this song. I hope we can just sing it, and then I will turn it over to the moderator. The song that says, "Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. Open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. I want to see you. To see you high and lifted up, shining in the light of your glory. Pour out your power and love as we sing holy, holy, holy. As we sing holy, holy, holy. I want to see you." May this be the cry of your heart. May this be the prayer of your heart, that I want to see with spiritual vision. God richly bless you.
Amen, amen, amen.